One of the most remarkable things about Clone Army Customs is just how consistent they've been ever since they opened. Their quality has always been top-notch, and their customer service has always been great. And it would be very easy to say that Clone Army Customs has never changed, but that simply isn't true. As I showed in my last video about them, they have actually changed several times, usually in small or subtle ways over the years. They've updated their website, their printing, and even their helmets. And when it comes to companies, no matter how long they've been around, changing things is just a natural part of growing. And without being willing to change, it's a lot harder to grow, both as companies and as people. When I first started this channel back in 2020, I made a rather negative review about AV figures. My experience with them was less than stellar, to say the least, so I made a video discussing all of what happened. Some of the points in that video I do still stand by, but some of them were really dumb to bring up and just unnecessary. But I also said, whether it was in that video or sometime shortly thereafter, that I wouldn't be purchasing from AV Figures anymore. Something which, if you have seen this channel recently, I no longer abide by. Why? Because AV Figures has changed so much since that point that they are no longer the same company that I first talked about. And I mean that in the absolute best way possible. There are some similarities between AV Figures and Clone Army Customs, but there are a lot of differences as well. While both companies are primarily run by only a single person, AV Figures is run by Andrew, literally out of his living room. Now, while Andrew certainly does have help, I bring this up to remind not just you, but also myself, that the scale of operation here is entirely different. While Clone Army Customs has been around for over a decade, AV Figures has only been in existence for 4 years. Andrew started this company when he wasn't satisfied with the career path that he was going to college for, so he decided to drop out and dedicate the time to something that he was much more passionate about, as he wanted to make a living off of his art. And so, combining that with a love of Lego, AV Figures was born. But make no mistake here, even though I'm making the comparison, when Andrew started this company, it was not intended to be a ripoff or a copy of Clone Army Customs, no pun intended. Andrew always wanted to do his own thing, and we see this primarily in what AV Figures has to offer, which is a wide variety of decals, more decals than you will find at any other store. If there is a Legion in Star Wars, then AV definitely has a decal for it. If there isn't a Legion in Star Wars, then AV probably has a decal for it. He has decals for every single type of clone that you can think of, from Phase 1 to Phase 2 to Airborne to ones that you probably haven't even heard of, like these knights. He has hundreds of different decals, all to your heart's desire. But it wasn't always this way. When I first started talking about AV Figures and following him, he also sold custom sets that either he designed or somebody designed and sold to him. Things like the Bad Batch Shuttle, or like the Jedi Interceptor, which I showed off at some point. And one of my biggest gripes at the time was, why? These sets were extremely expensive, much more than they should have been. Or at least I thought. AV Figures himself is actually pretty open and an incredibly nice guy, so I reached out to him asking about this, and he explained to me that custom sets actually require a lot from the seller up front, something which I also know to a lesser extent from my own store. But he went on to say that the profit margins, meaning the amount that AV actually made from each set sold, were still pretty slim, despite the high cost of the sets themselves. For instance, they sold the Bad Batch Shuttle for $400, a pretty high price tag, but it cost AV $300 just to produce the set in the first place. So it ended up only being a 33% markup, which is both actually pretty reasonable from a consumer perspective, and still pretty decent profit from a seller's perspective. Now, I have seen some people have 150% markups, so for instance, had AV Figures done that, the $300 shuttle would have sold for $750. So first of all, I'm very glad that they didn't do that. But the point that I'm making here is that regardless of the markup, the minimum that the set could have sold for is $350 anyway, just because of the cost that it took to produce. And of course, AV saw this, and he realized that all of the time, effort, and resources that went into producing each of these kits could have been better spent elsewhere, and specifically in places that could have helped serve more people at much lower costs. So AV Figures decided to stop making any custom sets and focus entirely on just the decals, and well, a little more. While the decals are still absolutely the bread and butter of AV Figures' business and the vast majority of their sales, in 2022, they also started offering fully printed minifigures. These are 360-degree printed minifigures that include clones, Jedi, Sith, and Inquisitors. Sometimes the helmets tend to be decaled, and that's alright as it fits in perfectly fine with the printed aspect. I have several of these minifigures now, and every single one is absolutely top-notch. There's a reason that I do AV Figures April for my minifig showcases. His minifigures are absolutely worth it. And what I love about this is his understanding as to why he started doing this. Because it's not about whether decaled figs or printed figs are better. That is and always will be a personal choice that only you and you alone can make. But I personally don't have much free time in my days anymore. If I'm not working at like my actual job, I'm usually working on one of my several YouTube channels. Or I'm asleep. And that just means that I don't really have the time to do something like decal a minifigure anymore. But I do like AV Figures designs, and so these printed versions allow me to still enjoy his work for a little bit more cost, but without having to put in much effort on my end. Now, yes, AV Figures printed minifigs are a little more expensive than you will see elsewhere, especially when compared to Clone Army Customs. However, there is a reason for this. There are actually two reasons for this. The first is that a lot of the helmets are decaled by hand, that is man hours that needs to be accounted for and paid accordingly. And the second is actually something that I'm going to talk a lot more about in a future video in this series. But for now, it's pretty awesome to know that whether you have the time to do the decals yourself or not, you can still enjoy these minifigures either way. And he does plan to extend what he has available through the printed side of things. Like I've mentioned a few times now, a lot of the helmets are hand decaled, but he plans to expand that and change it to have pad printed helmets as well. Which is actually pretty big news, because right now, all of his minifigures are actually UV printed. And again, if you want to know the difference between the two, well, that's the next video in the series, so make sure you subscribe to stick around for that one. But just like Clone Army Customs, AV Figures also offers a wider variety than just minifigures. He has a bunch of accessories, including individual helmets, weapons, and of course attachments for your minifigures. And these come in a few different varieties like ABS plastic or being 3D printed items. He also has a wide variety of cloth items for your minifigures, and he has his own version of custom clone helmets, which I personally prefer much more than the Clone Army Customs version. He also gives full credit to those who have designed decals for him, making sure that they have a page of their own so you're never in any doubt of who made the design. And if you've never done a decal before, but you'd want to get started, well, AV also has you covered with his tools page where you can literally get whatever you need right there. Now, it's really interesting to me because in some of the questions that I asked AV, one of them was what is one thing he would like to see happen with AV figures in 2023? And he gave me a very short and precise answer. I'd like to see us enter the pad printing market and offer things on par with CAC and LCM. If you don't know who LCM is, they're another video in this series. And the funny thing is, I kind of think he already does. Once AV reorganized, moved away from the custom sets and focused entirely on the minifigures, both decals and printed, I think the quality of the company as a whole increased tremendously. I have had no issues with them at all in this past year. Customer service has always been fantastic, orders have shipped in a timely fashion, everything has been perfect. And again, full disclosure, I have focused primarily on the printed minifigures just because I don't have the time to decal, but every single one has been top-notch and high quality. And I personally find some of AV figures' designs to be much more accurate and better than similar figures offered from other sellers. So when he says that this was a passion project for him, I can see that in every single design he makes, because he's not cutting any corners, he's not trying to do things just for money. He wants to make the best minifigure that he can every single time. And this is one of the key areas that allows him to stand out from the rest. They have a unique and deeper understanding of minifigure design, which allows them to create designs that look much more professional and work seamlessly with the unique geometry that is a minifigure. As AV Figures himself says, he likes to think that their design language meshes well with what LEGO would look like if they had the budget to make highly detailed figs. And I agree. There's this whole aspect of the LEGO community and the custom LEGO community over whether or not custom LEGO is over detailed compared to what real LEGO is. And look, there are people out there who sell plain minifigures if that's what you're into. But for me, a custom minifigure is worth that extra design, and places like AV and Clone Army Customs do a perfect job at that. And I also wanted to briefly mention that if you don't like Star Wars, don't worry, AV Figures does plan to eventually expand. After all, he's not called Star Wars Figures. I stole that directly from him. Andrew, if you're watching this, yeah, I stole that directly from you. He has some awesome stuff planned for the very near future, which I don't know if he's talked about yet, and I am definitely not the guy to do that, so I'll just let him talk about it if and when he wants to. All you need to know is that I am very excited for it. But what I can tell you is that he does also plan to expand into things like Halo, Marvel, military, Call of Duty, and even more. But right now, his production capacity is a little limited, so just be a little patient with that, as it will eventually happen. Now, with all of that said, before I end this video, there was one aspect of this that I already briefly mentioned, but I just wanted to talk a little bit more in depth about, as it will come back up later in this series. And that is, again, the cost of AV figures, as it does tend to be a little higher than competitors. Now, while I understand that there are man hours involved in this, I've asked him about this, and AV responded by saying, "I think the best analogy is grocery shopping. If you want to buy a single can of Coke, it costs like $1.50. If you want to buy a six pack, it costs $6. But if you go to Costco and get a 36 pack of cans, it's $20 and you get way more fluid ounce per dollar. Likewise, our cost slash unit produced varies on the quantity we make. We do not mass produce things like Clone Army Customs, so we have to get something in the medium quantity. If we're going off the Coke analogy, we're like that six pack. Our cost slash unit is not as high as a small run would be, but not bulk pricing. either. And that is incredibly important to remember. If AV Figures was able to have a level of production at the same scale as Clone Army Customs, then his cost per unit would go down. And while anything can happen, hopefully AV Figures will stick around for another 5 years and continue to grow so that he can up his production. Not just to have lower prices, but because I would genuinely love to see what else he has to offer. To me, it is truly amazing to see just how much has changed over the last 2 years, and all for the better. So while I had some harsh words to say the first time around, this time I have nothing but praise. AV Figures is absolutely worth checking out. Whether you're into decals or just want some awesomely designed minifigures, it's definitely worth seeing what he has to offer. As always, I'll leave a link in the description down below, but I would love to hear your stories and experiences with AV. So please, leave them in the comments as I would love to read them. Also, if you could do me a favor, remember to hit that subscribe button and like this video to help me out with the algorithm. And this is part 2 of a 5-part series. Next time we'll be looking at the difference between pad printing and UV printing. So thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.